Hello dear friends, today we are continuing with our pawn endgame series. In this video we will learn an instructive position again by Angrier Grip. So let's check out. In this position it is white to play and win. I would like to request you, please pause the video and think as white, what will you play in this position? In this version, white's best move is b4, king d4, king e6. At the first glance, everything looks normal, but that's not the story. h6, c3 check. In this version, if we place king into c3, then a5, b into a5, b into a5, and this pawn will just simply promote into a queen. So let's get back to the position. So that's why after c3 check, black played king c4, king e5, h5, king f5, c6, king g5, king d5. In this position, black is trying to get the distance up position, but it won't work now. King h4, c5, b5. No, don't play this capture b into c5 by mistake, because king into c5, king into h5, king c4, king g4, king into c3, king f3, king b4, king e2, king into a4, and black has a clear win. So again, let's back to the position where we are continuing with our main line. That's why he played b5, c4, king into h5, king d6, king h6, king d5, king g7, king e6, king g6. White has successfully gained their position. King e7, king f5, king d6, king f6, king d7, king e5, king e7, king d5, king d7. In this position, black has gained the position, but it won't work now after king into c4. Here now black cannot take the position. King d6, king b4, king d7, a5, b into a5, king into a5, king c7, and white has a clear win in this position. So let's get back to the starting position. So after king d4, here he played king e6, because the king is again using the dual purpose idea, as we have discussed before in previous videos about the Rates idea. So what is the dual purpose, and I mean what the threats the king is giving in this position? The first threat is in this position is that king d7, king into c7 gobble up, bring this queenside pawns. And the second threat is, even if Black tries to promote this pawn, then the king would catch up that pawn because the king is inside the square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the king is inside, both the kings are inside the this h pawn square, so this king can easily hold up that pawn. So he played h6, playing as simply and waiting move. Here white tried to give black a trap. C3 check, king c4, king e5, h5, king f5. As the dead wolf, purpose king is going for the second threat. C6, king g5, king d5, king h4, c5, b5, c4, king into h5. Here he played c4, not playing king c4, because after king into h5, king into c3, he will play a5, b into a5, b6, a4, b7, a3, b8, queen, and white wins the pawn race, and the king is already cut off by the queen. Yeah. Here he is cut off by the queen and can't reach on the A file to draw the game. So that's why here in this after king c4, white wins. Black just gets crushed. King d6, king h6. King d5, king g7, king e6, king g6, maintaining a position, king e7, king f5. As we have realized in this position, this king has already gobbled up the h file pawn, and now he is going to gobble up this other pawns on b and c5. As that dual purpose king has become now single purpose king. D6, king f6, king d7, and white wins as he just goes here, king e5, king d5, king d4, then later on just go on again on d5, c6, and b6. Bubble up also this pawn. So thank you, that's all for this video, and also don't forget to click the subscribe button and the bell icon below the video. And if you like my videos also, you can click the like button below the video. Thank you and have a nice day.